said to the boll weevil, I see you at my door. Yes, sir, said the boll weevil, I've been there before. Gonna get your home, gonna get your home. Farmer said to the grocer man, I want some meat and meal. Get out of here, you son of gun, you got boll weevil in your field. Gonna get your home, gonna get your home. Farmer said to the banker, I want to make a note. Get out of here, you son of gun, you got a boll weevil on your coat. Gonna get your home, gonna get your home. Farmer said to the dry goods man, I want to cash a check. Get out of here, you rascal, boll weevil down your back. Gonna get your home, gonna get your home. Farmer said to the finance man, I'd like to get a car. Get out of here, you so-and-so, got a boll weevil in your hair. Gonna get your home, gonna get your home. In this part of Texas where I was working in this whiskey store, some of the worst dust storms in the history of the whole world, I guess, broke loose. That was the big middle of the dust bowl. John Steinbeck talks about one end of the dust bowl, and that's the Oklahoma end of it. And other people talk about the Colorado and the New Mexico end of it. But if you want to find the very big middle of these dust storms where they get the blackest and the thickest, where the wheat grows, the oil flows, and the farmer owes. Now you just go to Amarillo, Texas, and you can spit within walking distance around there. You'll find you a good dust storm to deal with. Here's a picture here, Alan. I'd like for you to look at that. That there is the little town of Pampa, Texas. That's where my wife and three children are living right now, and I hear about from them about twice a week. This is March, and it's their windy season down there again, and she says they're still having same old dust storms. What do you think about that picture?
It looks like about the most awful thing I ever saw, a black cloud about 2 miles high coming over some little old shacks and chicken houses and stuff. Is that the kind of a house that people live in down there in Pampa?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's dwelling houses. I mean, for chickens and for...
Well, what happened the night that first dust storm hit, or the day it first hit? Do you remember just exactly what you people did and what you said?
Well, now, you see this picture here. It shows you the big dust storm coming up. And, you know, just to see a thing of that kind coming towards you, you wouldn't know exactly what it was because it's a freak-looking thing. You never saw anything like it before. But we all sat there. We had seen dust storms of every other different color, flavor, description, style, fashion, shade, design, model. But anyway, I remember the particular evening of April the 14th, 1935, that this dust storm here blowed up. I was standing, a whole bunch of us was standing, just outside of this little town here that you see. And so we watched the dust storm come up like the Red Sea closing in on the Israel children. Anyway, we stood there and watched the son of a gun come up. And I'm telling you, it got so black when that thing hit, we all run into the house, and all the neighbors had all congregated in different houses around over the neighborhood. We sat there in a little old room, and it got so dark that you couldn't see your hand before your face. You couldn't see anybody in the room. You could turn on an electric light bulb, a good, strong electric light bulb in a little room just about the size of this studio here. And that electric light bulb hanging in the room looked just about like a cigarette a-burning. And that was all the light that you could get out of it. So we got to talking, you know, and a lot of people in the crowd that was religious-minded, and they was up pretty well on the scriptures, and they said, well, boys, girls, friends and relatives, this is the end.
So these people believed that the world had come to the end, huh?
Yep.
Were the women crying and screaming and going on?
No, Alan, you'd be surprised. They wasn't. Wasn't nobody in that whole crowd is that way. And you see, the real thing, right face to face with you, why, most people are pretty level-headed. They just said, well, this is the end. This is the end of the world. People ain't been living right. Human race ain't been treating each other right. Been robbing each other in different ways with fountain pens, guns, and having wars and killing each other and shooting around. So, the feller that made this world, he's worked up this dust storm. And there's never been nothing like it in the whole history of the world. Even the old-timers that lived there for 50 years said they'd never seen anything like it to even compare with it. And he said, yep, that's right. Somebody has robbed somebody. Some of us is about to starve to death. Others spend $5,000 or $6,000 on a little party at night. Some lose $5,000 or $10,000 across a gambling table at night. Just nicely ain't been living right. So this dust storm is the end. And their conversation just run like that about the what is right and what is wrong, and that they kindly was wondering if they had done right all their life, and anyway they was hoping they had, because the time had come when the river was there to cross, and everybody said, well, so long, it's been good to know ye. Let her come. And did you start to say something?
Yeah, didn't the preachers have anything to say about all this? I believe you sang a song about that the other day, will you?
Yeah, I sung one about that, about all the church houses was full, you know, around over the whole country, and they was phoning up from one place to another, all the church people was, trying to get them to come up to church for the last time and get straight and get right and get on the good side and go across white as snow. So we was, I made up a little song there. That's kind of one of my own making, though. It's called So Long, It's Been Good to Know You.